Mustangs, I'm Parker Mason.
And I'm Gavin Thrash.
Here with your broadcast for the week of January 11, 2021. Welcome to the new year, Mustangs.
Hey Parker, I wonder what's going on in school.
Well, Gavin, here's Paige with your answer.
Hey Mustangs, I'm Paige O'Meara with your school news for this week. To start us off, the last week of the semester is next week, so make sure that you're getting all of your assignments turned in and talking to your teacher if you're failing any classes. The school is planning on collecting books from last semester and distributing books for this next semester. So if you have any books, for example, if you've already read a book for your English class, you can turn it into the vestibule located in front of the school. It will be open on weekdays during school hours, and you can start bringing your books in within the next 2 weeks. Just make sure that your name is written in the front of the textbook and that you've let your teacher know that you've turned it in. When the second semester begins, there will be videos being released to students that are about changes that are coming our way, especially for students that are doing in-person learning for the next quarter. So make sure that you check your emails for that. That's all we've got for this week, Mustangs. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Paige. Parker, what are you doing?
Well, I'm trying to do the once popular dance called the Renegade. Can you still do it?
Nope. I wonder who can. Let's see.
Hey Mustangs, I'm sure all of us have had trending TikTok sounds and dances stuck in our head for what seems like forever. Today we're gonna see if any of our students remember the Renegade. Seems like most of us still remember it pretty well. Thanks Carter, Aiden, Jillian, Lauren, and Riley for sharing your videos. Back to you in the studio.
Great job, Emery.
Winter sports have started up again. I wonder what athletes have done over break.
I don't know. Let's hand it off to Devin.
Hey Mustangs, Devin Porter here with a quick update on extended fall sports. Your swimming team is prepping for state finals. Winter sports are scheduled to begin on January 15th. Check out PC Mustang Sports for information on tryouts. Now let's turn it over to Eli with an update on skiing.
Hey Mustangs, this week in athletics with the postponement of winter sports throughout the break, athletes found a different way to stay active. Bittersweet opened up for skiing and snowboarding, and some athletes are continuing to spend a lot of time there. Here are some of them now for the inside scoop.
Winter sports being pushed back is extremely unfortunate. I love to go skiing personally, and I definitely feel like going to a local resort like Bittersweet has helped keep me entertained.
It's unfortunate that winter sports were postponed this year because everybody was hoping on attending a sporting event or basketball game. And it's especially hard on the seniors because they potentially might not get their last season of their sport. And I've only been skiing once, but Bittersweet might be a good alternative this year because it's fun to go with your friends and hopefully I could get to the big hill one day.
I like going to Bittersweet, especially with my friends, just because it's another thing we can do these days to interact with each other.
Have fun and mask up out there. And if you want to go to Bittersweet to find a fun way to get through this winter, it's open from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. Hopefully we can look forward to getting sports back really soon. That's it for athletics. Back to you in the studio.
Thanks, guys. Now heading over to Emma for some news on your activities.
Hey there, Mustangs. Have you found yourself feeling a little bored lately? In that case, you should check out Ported Central Activities Instagram and Twitter to get involved with all the cool stuff we have to offer here at PC. Ported Central offers a wide range of clubs from knitting and crocheting, skiing, science, and even an optimist club. If none of these clubs float your boat, I'm sure one of the many other clubs and activities will draw you in. Check out the activity website, social media, or contact Ms. Smith with any questions. That's all for this week, Mustangs. Now back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Emma.
I miss when I could go out to the restaurants and eat.
Yes, I sure do miss Long John Silver's on West Ninja Avenue.
Well, let's see what places are still open. Hannah, what's cooking in P-Town?
Hey, Mustangs. Recent restrictions on restaurants have made some significant changes in how we eat around Portage. Many restaurants have stopped providing indoor seating, and as we move into the winter months, outdoor seating becomes more scarce. Today, we'll be covering some safe places to eat around Portage. The Cove Lakeside Bistro on Portage Road has had enormous success since it was first established in 2017. However, when the pandemic hit, they needed to change up the way that they were serving customers. As of now, Cove offers takeout options. PC student Lauren Norg worked at Cove before they were limited exclusively to takeout.
The takeout situation at Cove is basically like every other restaurant. You can go online, find the menu, and just call in an order. We also have these things called the pods where you can actually go and sit and eat.
There are many places around the Portage area that offer outdoor seating, such as Buddy's Pizza, Black Rock, Jack's, Traveler's Cafe and Pub, Main Street Pub, and others. All these options include heated patio space. Bird Dog and Madawan even offers heated igloos. Many of these places work by reservation, so make sure to schedule ahead of time. That's all for this week, Mustangs. See you next week and stay safe.
Thank you, Hannah. Now I sure am hungry.
Well, that's all for this week, Mustangs. Make sure to stay safe and stay positive.
I'm Gavin Thrash.
And I'm Parker Mason.
Signing off.
Have a great week, Mustangs.